Goa, the land not only known for its beautiful tourist destinations, but also the fascinating history of legends and rich heritage. Most of the richly filled heritage and traditional environments are found in the villages. One of such wonderful rural sites is Shapora.
सोबीत एके सायडीक दर्याचो बीच सगळी वेळ, एके सायडीक ही न्हंय, एके सायडीक दोंगर, एके सायडीक दोंगर आशिल्लो सोबीत गांव जेन्ना कोणाक दिसती पडलो तेणीन अशें म्हटलें, तेच्या तोंडांतल्यान अशीं उतरां येयलीं, काय सू सू म्हटल्यार सुंदर, काय सुंदर हो गांव आसा. तर चल्ल्यानूच ह्या गांवांक काय सू अशें नांव पडलें अशें हांव आयकता. पूण कितलें खरें फोट ह्या संदर्भान आजून म्हायती ना, पूण आजून पर्यंत कांय सू म्हणल्यार कांय बरो सुंदर असो गांव आनी आजुनूय सुबेगकाय ह्या गांवांत आसा. ते न्हंयेक लागून, ते शापोरा न्हंयेक लागून, ते सुंदर दर्याक लागून म्हणया. आनी एके सायडीक सगळें तुमकां दोंगर, जे 5-4 दोंगर दिश्टी पडटले, हो सोबीत असो हो गांव कांय सू गांव. The Shapora village is situated in North Goa at around 25 kilometers from the capital city Panjim. It lies on the banks of River Shapora. River Shapora runs westwards into the Arabian Sea and demarcates the border between Pernay Taluka and Bardes Taluka. Shapora is well known among the rural places in Goa due to the Shapora Fort, which is one of the chief landmarks built by the Portuguese. People of Shapora are peaceful, friendly, and fun-loving. The lifestyle here reflects an unique blend of social and cultural heritage. They comprise of Hindus, Christians, and Muslims. Being a coastal village, it is mostly dependent on fishing. And if for some it is not an occupation, then it's definitely their hobby.
खाडेन भितर गावता पळय न्हू ते गांवटी मुड्डश्यो म्हणून गांव शेतक्यो बुराटे शेवटायो पालो गेलो ते गांवटी भितर नुस्तें मारपी आसा न्हू बारीक केलो घेवन तेंकां गांवटी आनी आमी दर्यान भायर गेले काय ना आमकां ती सुंगटां माणक्यो इसवण बिसवण ते भायर पापलेटां बीन ते भायर गावता जे पणजे गावता मालीम पळय ते हांगर गावता आनी हांगर लोक येता व्हरपाकूय येता
लोकल
येता हॉटेलवाले येता आनी म्हापसाय वयता हांगरले म्हापसा मार्केटाक मेन आदी हांगरले नुस्तें म्हापसा मार्केटाक वयता आतां ते चड सरप्लस जाल्या कारणान ते कितें सगळेंच कांय विकूंक शकना त्या खातीर ते एजंटांक घालचे पडटा ते मागीर एजंट घेवन वयता गांवचे हय गांवचे हय सगळे लोक गांवचे भायले गांवचे सुद्दां हांगर व्हरपा हय
At one time, Shapura Trawler Fishing Jetty was considered as the largest jetty in North Goa, which is now the second largest.
कितें आसा आतां जेटी चालू आसा पूण आमच्यो सगळ्यो आख्ख्या गोंयान बोटी चालू आसा आनी आमच्योच बोटी बंद आसा कित्याक आमकां बरें सँडबार लागता थंयसर नासता खायसर पळय भायर वचपाचें बोटी भायर व्हरूंक मेळना तेकतात जमनी बोटी फुट्टात म्हणून आमचे आतां रावल्या आमी दर्या थंड जातलो आनी आमी चालू करतले म्हणून
ट्रॉलर आसले 100 वयर उरल्या 40 तेवूय ते फुटोवन फुट एक कांय फुटप आतां 4 जाले आतां ट्रॉलर सुरू जावन आमचो अजूनय ट्रॉलर म्हणजे ते उरता 8 महिन्यांसून ते हेका लागून सेंडबाराक लागून एक 4 ना 5 सारके ट्रॉलर चलता तितून काय आमचें हें जायना वॉकआउट जायना मनशांक हें घालपाक जाय पेमेंट घालपाक जाय मागीर वेअर एंड टेअर आसा बोटीचे प्लस मागीर आमच्या फॅमिलीचो हे आसा
दिस जेटी इज रीनोन सिन्स द पोर्चुगीज रूल इन गोवा It served as a point of anchorage where all Portuguese trades used to undertake commercial activities. In course of time, the jetty has undergone a great deal of transformation. It has seen many improvements in terms of concrete structures. But today, still the boat owners and laborers face several hardships.
आमकां मेन प्रॉब्लम आसा तो सँडबाराचो आसा आनी सँडबार आसल्या कारण आमकां जाय तेन्ना वचोंक गावना जाय तेन्ना येवंक गावना इतलो प्रॉब्लम जाता की एमर्जंसी कोण सीक जालो न्हू आनी ते येवपाक जाय न्हू पाणी बीन सकयल आसा न्हू आतां अशें पाणी आसा न्हू येवपाक गावना बोट थंय आदळटा तेन्ना आमकां चड प्रॉब्लम तो मेन डिमांड आसा आमचो पयलो आमचो सँडबार क्लियर करपाक बिजनस ओवरऑल तूं गेल्यार ते दर्याचेर आदारीत दर्याक पीक येता थंय ते पीक येता तेन्ना तुजे तर कंडिशन बरें आसा ट्रॉलर तर बरो हे आसा आनी आमकां सँडबारान तर हे केले जाल्यार आमकां ते केन्ना बरें गावता केन्ना बोट मोडली जाल्यार ते चुकता तो काय थंयसरूच ते हे जाय प्रोडक्शन थंयसरूच उरना ते चेंज जायत आसता दर्याचे
टुडे ड्यू टू मॉडर्न इन्फ्लुएंस Tremendous changes have taken place among the people in terms of occupation.
Service, government service, tourism, private and with that, tourism, body mata, motorcycle, which is called taxi, is all that, all that. And fishing, any kind of.
So the tourism among attracts all the asal. And hotel land in Gelde, asal lo casino jero ita kamang service karpa.
Room bade dita, foreigner jata nangra pa.
That the hotel jasti lok फिशरमॅन हे फिशिंगाचेर आदारीत रावले मागीर ट्युरिझम ट्युरिस्ट येवपाक लागले तेन्ना मागीर ते ट्युरिस्टा फाटल्यान गेले
द शापोरा विलेज ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रिब्युट्स टू द ट्युरिझम इंडस्ट्री बाय प्रमोटिंग देअर हॉटेल्स गिविंग हाऊसेस फॉर रेंट टू द ट्युरिस्ट अँड रनिंग रेस्टॉरंट्स दॅट सर्व सम ऑफ द बेस्ट गोवन कुझिन्स
पर्यटनाक लागून हे क्षेत्र खुबशे फास्ट डेवलप जाला कितलीशीच उदरगत हांगसर जावपाक लागल्या पर्यटक येवन ह्या गांवांत भेट दिल्या कारणान आनी त्या नुसार लोकांक थोडो भोव आर्थीक फायदोय जावपाक लागलो थोड़े पर्यटक या घरांनी येऊन सुद्धा भाड्याक रावतात आणि त्याकाय लागून एके साइडीक जर आम कोण रावता जाल्यार दुसरे साइडीक पर्यटकांक सुद्धा घरा दिवपाचो किंवा भाड्याक दिवपाचे थोडे एक सिजनल एक 3 महिन्यांक 4 महिन्यांक हे लोक दितात आणि तितूंतल्यान जो पयसो मेळटा तितून आपली उदरगत दर एका मनशाची उदरगत जायना फुडें त्या गांवची उदरगत जाता त्याच तरेन मनशान कायसुकारांनी आपली उदरगत करून घेतली आणि त्याच तरेन ह्या गांव कायसूची ह्या 30-40 वर्सांक बरोचसो फरक जाल्लो आमकां पळोवपाक मेळटा.
The rest traditional occupations carried out here are farming, toddy tapping, cow herds, and construction of boats. The least seen occupation is cow herding.
शेती म्हणटा पळय हो विषय जेन्ना येयलो तेन्ना शेती वांगडा जनावरां जाय पडलीं आनी ही जनावरां शेती ना जाल्यार जनावरां ना जाल्यार शेती जायना आनी शेती ना जाल्यार जनावरां जायना म्हणट्या प्रत्येक शेतकऱ्याक अशें दिलें की तेणी जनावरां पोसप आनी त्या जनावरां वयल्यान शेती करप. गाय पोसल्या उपरांत एके गायक बैल जालो जाल्यार त्या गाय बैलाक जोताक झोपप आनी शेती करप. गायेगेर वासरू जालें जाल्यार त्याच वासराची जोपासना करप आनी ताका बऱ्या मार्गान हाडून वरती फळळी भुरग्यां आसतना फळळी गाय जाली की ती दूद दिवप अशे पद्दतीन तें दूद विकप आनी त्या दुदानसून जे जे पयशे मेळटा तितून आपलो संवसारूय चलप आपल्या भुरग्यांकूय दूद दिवप आनी शेतीवाडी करप. हांव सकाळचो 4 उठ्ठा गोठो साफ करतां जनावरांक साफ करतां आनी तेच नंतर गोठो धुवप आसता आमचो. शेण भरलें म्हणून गोठो निवळ जायना तेन्ना मागीर धुवप आसता तो जनावरांक धुल्या उपरांत थोडेच गोठो आपुणशी साफ जाता आनी तेच नंतर हांव गोठो धुता आनी गोठो धुल्या उपरांत मागीर दूद काडूंक बसता. अशें करता मुरग्यांक मागीर दूद काडून जालें मागीर गोरवांक खावड दिवप आसता. खावड दिवन जाली की तेच नंतर मागीर हांव म्हाजें तोंड धुतां म्हाजी स्वच्छता आसता अशे पद्दतीन म्हाका 8:30 जाता आनी 8:30 नंतर हांव गोरवांक सोडप थोडीशी जागा इल्ली शेतांत पाड असल्या कारणान थंय तांकां सोडून हाडटा झाडाक घरा कडेन येता. आतांच्या परिस्थिती प्रमाणे जे सरकारान एक तरेचे नवे यंत्रणा तयार केल्या एक दर ट्रॅक्टर म्हणणा काय पावर टिलर म्हणणा काय अशा पद्दतीन जी यंत्रणा तयार केली तितून पळोवन लोकांक कितें दिसलें की गोरवां पासत खूब वाज गोरवां पासत खूब त्रास गोरवांक 12 महिने पोसूंक जाय यंत्र हाडलें घरान दवरलें ताका एक दीस सोय केली कितें म्हणजे साफ सफाई केली की यंत्र तशाचें तशें उरता पूण गोरवां तशाचें तशें उरना म्हणून गोरवां पासत लोक खूब खूब लांब लांब वयता.
Occupations are gradually changing and so does the private infrastructure.
जे कोण मातशे काम धंदो करून किंवा व्यवसाय करून किंवा सरकारी नोकरी ताका मेळ्या आनी ह्या तरेन जे वयर सरल्यात तांच्यांनी सुरवाती आपणाचे घरदार सारखे करपाचे प्रयत्न केलो आनी तितूंतल्यानूच अशी कितलीय हांगसर आमच्या वाड्यार सुद्दां हांव पळयतां की सुरवातीक जे गांवठी नळ्यांची जी घरां आसली किंवा मातयेच्या पाळ्यांची जी घरां आसली थंय आतां काँक्रीटचीं घरां किंवा स्लॅब घातलेलीं घरां आमकां पळोवपाक मेळटलें हो एक म्हत्वाचो फरक हांगसर जाल्लो आसा.
थिंग्स दॅट स्टील नीड टू बी डॅवलप्ड इन द विलेज आर द बेसीक पब्लीक एमिनिटीज.
मनशाचे तर रावपाचे हे आसा न्हू तांकां पयलीं रावपा सारके सुलभ शौचालय जाय सेकेंड मार्केट जाय दुसरें म्हणटा तें पार्कींग प्लेस जाय म्हणजे बशींग लोकांक येवपाक बशी रावपाक बस स्टॉप बीन तें मेन आसा. रोड हे बरें जावंक जाय कळ्ळें आयज रोड तर तुमी येता आसतना आतां पळयल्लें आसा रोडाचें कंडिशन कितें आसलें मून वक मूनार हे खड्डे पडलेले सारखे पडले.
In Chapora, one can come across well-maintained Portuguese houses. Some Portuguese houses are in ruins due to neglect. The river Chapora has its source in Ramghat Hills near Belgaum and enters Goa at Ibrampur village. It also has several islands which are stocked by mangroves reaching up to the Sal village. At Sal village, the river runs through water retaining walls also called as Bandara. Today, this site has become a picnic spot. Starting from Ibrampur, the villages that lie on the banks of this river are Alorna, Dargal, Tue, Agarwada, Chopde, and Morche in Perne Taluka. In Bardes Taluka, Pirna, Rivora, Kolwale, Kamulli, Oshel, Sioli, and the last Chapora, after which the river is named. Economic activities carried out along river Chapora other than fishing are sand extraction at Kamulli and Kolwale, salt making at Agarwada, and cruising at Chopde. National Highway 17 passes on the bridge over the Chapora River, which connects Kolwale village to Dargal, and the other bridge over this river connects Siolim to Chopde. Also, Konkan Railway passes on this river from Revora to Dargal. River Chapora is the lifeline for all the villages on its banks. Among all these villages, Chapora is significant in terms of heritage site due to the Chapora Fort.
The original, the etymological roots, as per my opinion, is that the village was called Shahpur, okay? And it was an Adil Shahi garrison was stationed there on the hill, okay? So it was from Adil Shah, you get that etymological roots as Shah. Pur is suffixed to Shah, thereby making it Shahpur, which means town of the Adil Shah. Pur means town or city, it's a Sanskrit word. And Shah means king. And here it is obviously a reference to the Adil Shah. Because Adil Shah was ruling over Goa, and that part, the hill is there, there was an Adil Shahi fort which later on Portuguese conquered and rebuilt. okay, which is today famous as the Shapura Fort. See, this fort is strategically located on top of the hill. If you visit the Vagator beach, and overlooking the Vagator beach is the hill, and on top of the hill there is this fort, Shapura Fort. Okay, and it is commanding a very panoramic view of the Arabian Sea. At the foot of the Shapura Fort, the Shapura River flows, which merges into the sea. And across the Shapura River on the other side is the village of Morji. Okay, you have Morji, Ashwe, Mandre, and the whole Pedne Taluka. So it is strategically located. So the Portuguese conquered this fort from the Adil Shah and wholly rebuilt. And it was rebuilt during the time of Count of Eritrea, who was the Portuguese governor, completed in 1717. During the time of Portuguese, that Shahapur was corrupted to Shapura. And the Shapura fort has a long history. It was Adil Shahi fort. The garrison of Adil Shah was stationed over there. It was strategically located. Then in 1683, it was captured by Sambhaji. In 1717, Portuguese rebuilt the fort. And then in 1739, when the Marathas invaded Portuguese territory, that is Bardez, Tiswadi, Sansir, this fort provided shelter to the people of Bardez. They hid themselves there. Okay? Original name of Shapura before Adil Shah is Kaisur. Even today, some people call it Kaisur.
जेटीच्या कुशीक आसा तो फोर्टाचो एक भाग म्हणू येता, फोर्ट न्ही, जाका आमी चॅक पोस्ट म्हणू येता. कितें आतां जर येरादारीची साधनां आमी पळयतात, पुर्तुगेजांच्या वेळार अशें म्हणटात किंवा तेच्या पयलीं आदिलशाहाच्या वेळार सुद्दां की नकळत नाका जाल्ली फौज जर कोणी तारवान भितर येता जाल्यार हो जो फोर्टाचो हे किल्ल्याचो भाग आसा थंयसरल्यान तांकां दिश्टी पडटाले आनी थंयसरल्यानूच त्या तारवांचेर हे म्हणया तोफां ज्यो आसा किंवा त्या वयले जे कितें तारवां फोडपाचे फोडपाक लागून तोफांत आसतल्यो त्यो चडश्यो करून त्या तोफेंतल्यान गोळी भार ह्या भागांतल्यान त्या तारवांचेर जातालो.
The State Archaeology Department, I'm very sorry to say this, has not paid any attention to the fort, although the fort is beautifully located, perched on a hill, like a crown of the hill. And if you go inside the fort and if you stand there on the ramparts of the fort, you get a beautiful view of the surrounding areas. And in many of the films, it has been showcased, it has been shown in some of the films. So when such an important, beautiful fort is there, it is allowed to overgrow with vegetation. There's a lot of vegetal growth over there. There is absolutely no conservation done of the fort. Parts of the fort are falling. Several times we have made petitions to the State Archaeology Department, but it is in vain because they don't seem to be interested at all. Students have a very important role to play because the students are the future. You all are the future. When you use the word posterity, all this heritage should be preserved for posterity is for you. Okay? Even a letter from a group of students to the State Archaeology Department or to the Panchayat or to the TCP Department or to the North Goa Collectorate regarding the fort will help in a long way, finally, in the preservation of the fort. Because the students should, first of all, students should be aware, students should visit it.
The Shapura Fort is also known as Dil Chahta Hai Fort among tourists. Dil Chahta Hai is one of the mainstream Bollywood films which became huge hit with the audience. A scene from the tour sequence of this film was shot on this fort.
Tumhi ya gaavan ane ek pulaitlyan की कायसू गांवांत सगळीं घरां जीं आसा तीं एकाच मजल्याचीं आसतलीं, दुसरो मजलो हांगसर ना अशी लोकांची थोड्यांची मान्यताय आसा. की हो जो सिद्धेश्वर दैवत जें आसा, किंवां सिद्धेश्वर देव आसलो, हो धव्या घड्यार बसोन गांवांत तेजी पासय आसताली आनी वयरसून कोणी तेजेर कितें उडोवचें न्हय की दुसऱ्या मदल्यार रावून गांवांतल्यान वयता आसतना एक मान्यता अशी जावन पडल्या की ह्या गांवांत डबल फ्लोर किंवां दुसऱ्या मजल्याचें घर बांदचें न्हय. आनी अशें पळयल्यात तुमी गांवांत क्वचित तुमकां डबल फ्लोर आशिल्लीं घरां तुमकां दिश्टी पडटलीं. ह्या गांवाचो म्हत्वाचो उत्सव जो म्हणटा तो म्हटल्यार स्वामी अच्युतानंद सिद्धेश्वराच्या कृपेन किंवां स्वामीच्या कृपेन जो उत्सव लोक हांगसर व्हडा धबाल्यान 15 दीस सारको मनयता तो म्हटल्यार शिगमोत्सव. होळयेक सुरू जाता तो पाडवो पर्यंत पाडव्याक तेजी सांगता जाता किंवां पाडव्याक तो शेवट जाता. ह्या तरेन 15 दिसांचो शिगमो म्हाका दिसता कायसू गांव सोडून आनी गोंयांत खंयच जायना. हें एक म्हत्वाचें. आनी दुसरो जे आमचे स्वामी अच्युतानंद महाराज जे आसा तांचे पुण्यतिथीचो हो कार्यक्रम ह्या शिगम्याच्याच दिसांनी तो जाता. आनी हे दोनूय मेळून हे कार्यक्रम जो जाता व्हड दबाज्यान कायसूचे लोक खंयच्याय गांवांत भायर आसुनी परदेसांत आसुनी ते मुद्दाम ह्या पालखेक लागून कायसवा येता. आनी हो सगळ्यांत व्हडलो उत्सव हो कायसू गांवचो उत्सव जावन आसा. त्यान भायर आमचे ग्रामदैवतां आसा ती भुमिका माता म्हण नाकाय, मागीर श्री सिद्धेश्वर दैवत म्हण नाकाय. ह्या सिद्धेश्वर दैवताचो एक वाडदिवस जाता ह्या पाडव्याच्या 15 दिसांनी हो तेजो वाडदिवस जाता. ह्या वाडदिवसूय एक म्हत्वाचो ह्या गांवचो कार्यक्रम आसा. ह्या वाडदिवसाक जर तुमी पळयशात ज्यो बायलांक एक खास थंय दिवास पेटोवपाचो कार्यक्रम जाता तुमकां ह्या वाडदिवसाच्या निमतान जाल्लो पळोवपाक मेळटलो.
Shapora's neighboring village Siolim also follows the similar cultures and traditions, but it hosts many festivals and traditional activities than Shapora. Large area of Khazan lands are found in Siolim, which are agricultural lands protected by bunds from inundation by the river, and the internal water bodies are connected to the river by sluice gates, also called as manas. It is said that Siolim has contributed to the Goan art and culture. Many artists, musicians, sportspersons, bishops hail from this village.
La ra la ra chi aik tin ka ta ra.
As a child, I only came to Siolim to visit my grandmother, and it was always a wonderful experience because it was like going into this place where there was no electricity, first of all. So at sunset, everything was dark, and there were these lamps which were lit up. You know, there was a Petromax, and there were kerosene lamps. And I still remember that. Once a week or something, one car might pass this side. At that time, it was like, Gadi Eli, Gadi Eli, Gadi Eli. We would all run, all the kids would run in front to see that car. It was like an event. You know, when I first came to live in Siolim, after a few years, there was, the politicians were trying to make, for the first time, they were trying to make a divide between the Hindus and the Catholics in Goa. At that time, it was in the early 80s. And at that time, I heard about the Zagor, and a friend of mine called Uli, he expired now, he invited me to, you know, to come and sing there. And I always thought that Zagor was a, you know, was a Hindu festival. I said, are you sure that I can come? He said, are you joking? Of course you can come. He said, Zagor is a mixture of Hindu and Christian. I said, really? And I said, in that case, of course I will come, because I was all for promoting, you know, harmony and friendship between the two communities. And I went there and I learned so many things about it, which I never knew. You know, that the main, you know, dancing of the Zagor dance itself is done by a Christian family. And for generations. And all those prayers that they were singing also, they sounded like Hindu prayers. But some of the words, when the Purohit recited them to me, said, Poyla Deo Jesu Christu Ani Maria, they said, you know, so many, you know, Christian names of gods, and they were recited in a very Hindu, you know, shloka or a mantra kind of way. That's why I fell in love with this festival. I said, this is exactly what Goa needs. Sometimes it's an angry song, sometimes it's a love song, sometimes it's a song about beautiful nature, and sometimes it's a senseless song just having a good time.
I love you, love you, love you, love you, Sonio. Oh, Sonio, oh, moja, Sonio.
I would say not only about Siolim but about North Goa in general. I think we should take an example from the villages in South Goa. The villages in South Goa have started in opposing all the big constructions which are coming there. And what are the big constructions? They're not for Goans.
Goa, Goa, tuji girestai. Goa, Goa, anka tuji sasai. Goa, Goa, asa tuji sasai.
If we are close to nature, then we are close to God. And if we respect God, then we should respect nature. Here we are destroying nature and we are shouting in the name of God.
Siolim has witnessed vast difference from the last few years to the present.
Adi gaav beshto rasto beshto aslo. Ajo gaav sarpanch aslo tenna magir o rasto kela. Nale beshti cholo chi vaat asli, gaadyang suddha vaat nasli. Sheta chod asli ni maad kaadi. Maad kattale. Ata lokani sagra te maad kami kele. Ani ata shikla lok to sagra सिरीज करतात शेतां आदी सगळो लोक शेतां पा आदी अळसाणो पा रोपेलाय काने जाता न्हू ते काने जाताले भाजी जाताली आमच्या सगळ्या गांवांत आतां ते लोकांनी सगळे बंद केलां ते आमी जाणटे आहा पळय ती हांकां सांगता भुरग्यांक हे तुमी आदले काम आहा पळय ते चालू करा तुमकां आमची भुरगीं सगळें काम करी शेण भरी शेतान वचा तण हाडपाक वचा आतां जे भुरगे कितें शिकता खेळटा आनी टी वी पळयतात आनी कितें करता.
दो सियोलिम इज अ डेवलपींग विलेज, वन कॅन नॉट ओनली कम अक्रॉस मल्टी स्टोरी रेसिडेंट्स अँड न्यू कन्स्ट्रक्शन्स बट ऑल्सो वेल मेंटेन पोर्च्युगीज अँड ओल्ड हिंदू हाऊसेस.
Nine. केन्ना बांदलो तें
केन्ना बांदलो मागीर तूं हिशोब कर मुगो कितलो जाता
Hindu house Sri Sateri Prasanna is now maintained by the third generation.
म्हणजे आदले असेच असले
आदले आता आहे
दा फरक काहीच करू ना
रिन्यू होत आहे काय करू
असे असले तसेच केले फरक काय करू ना
This is the oldest house in Siolim and is registered at Goa Heritage. एका आजचे
नाव दोनला ओ पांडुरंग म्हणजे आमच्या घरान कशी पद्धत जाणते मे देखा भुरगी जाता त्यांचे नाव दवरपाची तसे एका ते नाव दवरला आता हे सगळ्याचे मेंटेन कोण करता होच करता कळे त्रास म्हणजे आणि किती करतले घरान खूप जणा म्हटलं कोण हेल्प करीना आम्ही चौघा जणा राहतो आम्ही दोघा आणि आमची दोघा चेडवा आणि एक चुलत माया
The 90-year-old Portuguese house was built by Anton Caetan Suze Agos de Souza and is now maintained by the fourth generation.
The degree is from 28th of November 1882.
This is the largest Portuguese house in Siolim. The St. Anthony Church of Siolim holds importance among people for its mysteries and myths.
सुरुवातीक ती गांवसभा डॉ सियोली थंयसर बांदलेली मागीर ती थंयसर बांदपाचे बंद केले आनी मागीर हांगा मारना बांदपाक सुरू केले 1901 थंयसर ती कोणशाक कशी पडटली हांगा ती सेंट्रली लोकेटेड पडटली त्या खातीर तो जागो बदललो ते भितर आसले हे सारके मोदें कशे आनीक सो वर्सां घेतली चर्चीचो भाग सोंपोवपाक 1907 December 20 तो भाग सोंपलो हांगा तांकां इगोज बांदतना आटकळ मेळ्ळ्यो म्हणजे काम करतना त्या कामदारांक एक व्हडलो स्वरूप त्रास दिवपाक लागलो ते भियेले हांगा इगोर्ज बांदपाची बी बंद करूंक सोदताले दुसरे कडेन वचूंक सोदताले पूण मागीर ताणें एक सांतातोरीची मुर्ती धाकटी वणतींत घातली आनी मागलें देवा कडेन सांतातोरी कडेन म्हणजे हो वावर बरे भाशेन सुरू करूंक आदार दिया आनी तो बरे भाशेन सोंपय म्हण आनी मागीर तो स्वरूप व्हडलो स्वरूप जो कामदारांक त्रास करतालो तो मागीर सांतातोरीची मुर्ती अशी येवन तो मेलो
The St. Anthony Church celebrates the feast of St. Anthony in June, where people from whole Goa participate. Among all the festivals, Sanjaw is the most famous in Siolim. It is the feast of St. John the Baptist celebrated on June 24th.
Hey, how are you?
The special attraction about this feast in Seolim is the boat festival. The main temples of the village celebrates famous satras and festivals. Shri Datta Mandir is known for the festival of Guru Purnima, Datta Jayanti and Guru Dwadashi. Shri Sateri Temple is known for Diwsa. Shri Bandareshwar Temple, which is at the banks of the river Shapura, celebrates Narli Purnima. And the most important of all, Shri Jagreshwar Temple, which celebrates the festival of Jagor.
There is this Jagor, and which takes place in the month of December. So that Jagor I have seen, it is a kind of a syncretic Jagor, you know, that the Christians as well as Hindus participate in it. Because originally it was a Gowda who were performing the Jagor. Jagor is Jagyarao, that is keeping the spirits awake. Okay, and on the Mand they perform the Jagor. And in the case of after conversion, the Shiolkars, that is the Gowda Christians, still follow the Jagor. It's the Christian Jagor, and they have syncretic elements of both. And there is this Jagorio. So that is a beautiful facet of syncretic culture in Goa.
बरें जावपाचें गांवान हीं भुरगीं कोण खोटे हितून वयता पळय तीं बरें रस्त्यान येवचीं जावं चेडे चेडवां बरें करचें तेंच्यांनी जाणट्यांचें कितें बरें सांगता पळय तें आयकपाचें भुरग्यांनी न्हू
People make homes, homes make a village. Village nurtures the people, and so does the people to the village.
Cut the lantern.